There is a great and immortal Kiswahili saying that he or she who does not recognize his or her culture will be eternally a slave. The time has come for Africa and Africans to demand of the world that we can no longer afford the misfortune of communing with other civilizations as if we are children of a lesser God. We can no longer be nostalgic of the past without projecting into the future. We have come here in order to celebrate the future as informed by the past, that for a long time we have judged ourselves too harshly, that the time has now come that we must recognize ourselves for who we are. You know, our civilization was rudely interrupted. It was a rude interruption that saw some of our men and women being spirited away into other parts of the world. And today, as I speak to you, Africa has 55 artificial boundaries. We have come here today to dramatize the artificiality of those boundaries so that we may have that day when I can move from Nairobi, Kenya to Lagos in Nigeria without the necessity of a visa. I look forward to those days. When I shall move from Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, and I only have one currency to contend with, not 38 currency. I look forward to the day when Hollywood and Bollywood will no longer have a place in our television, and Nollywood and Riverwood and Bongowood would be what we watch. I look forward to those days. And I'm reminding ourselves and the young men and women that that can happen and that will happen, but that we must work at it. Throughout history, countries and places have changed because young men and women have taken a resolve. Oh, fellow Africans, I see Africa rising so that when we meet with the rest of civilization, they will be able to say, lo and behold, the Negroes are capable of delivering, and that the Negroes are capable of producing, and that the Negroes are not children of a lesser God.